Which breed is best for you, Akita versus Shiba Inu? Both of these dog breeds come from Japan. They each have triangular, pointed ears, and a fluffy curled tail that look quite fox-like. These breeds also come in very similar colors. But, there are some key differences between the Akita versus Shiba breeds that you should learn before committing to one. Let's find out more to see which is right for you. Before we move on with this video, you need to grab the free dog training secrets guide in which I have disclosed the deepest dog training secrets that professional dog trainers don't want you to know about. These training secrets would help you have a well-behaved, super intelligent, smart and obedient dog without spending hours in training him, her. Link to the free, secret training technique guide is in the description below. It's important to remember that neither of these breeds is better than the other. But, we will be able to help you decide which one is better suited to your family and home. Akita versus Shiba Inu history. Both the Akita and Shiba Inu breeds have ancient histories that originate in the same country, Japan. Akita history. The Akita breed comes from a line of hunting dogs known as the Matagi. The Matagi breed were used for hunting large animals like bears, boars, and deer. Their strength, bravery, and size made them great hunters. Matagi dogs are known in Japanese history for being one of the oldest native dog breeds. But, this isn't the only dog breed involved in the modern-day Akita breed. The Akita was brought across to America in 1938 by Helen Keller, who received one as a gift when visiting Japan. Shiba Inu history. The Shiba Inu was also originally a hunting breed used in mountainous regions in Japan. This breed actually dates back to 300 BC. They originally hunted large game, but as the breed developed, they were used on smaller animals. During 7th century AD, the Japanese Yamato court set an initiative to maintain native dog breeds as part of Japan's culture. They set up a dog keeper's office to help achieve this. The Shiba Inu was one of these native breeds. But, Shibas did face hardship when they almost went extinct in the Second World War. The government managed to keep the breed alive with a survival program and three remaining bloodlines. It wasn't until 1954 that the first Shiba Inu was documented in America. But, the breed wasn't recognized by breed registries there until the 1990s. Akita versus Shiba Inu fun facts. Shiba, in Japanese, can refer to this dog's red fur color as well as brushwood in the mountains where these dogs originally hunted. But Inu, just means dog. So, you may also hear the Akita breed called, Akita Inu. There's also a beautiful story surrounding the Akita. In the 1920s, an Akita named Hachiko would follow his owner to the train station every morning. After his owner died, Hachiko waited by the train station for 9 years, until he passed away. He waited for his owner, even when other people tried to bring him home and care for him. Hachiko's loyalty earned him a statue memorial at the Shibuya train station, which you can even visit now. Akita versus Shiba Inu appearance. Although appearance doesn't make much of a difference in how well suited a dog is to your family, you might want a dog that looks a particular way. Let's find out how the Akita Shiba appearances compare. Size. One of the major differences between these breeds is their size. Akitas are much bigger than Shiba Inus. Akita dogs will grow up to 28 inches tall, weighing between 100 and 130 pounds when fully grown. Shibas, on the other hand, can reach 16.5 inches tall, weighing up to 23 pounds. So, they're a lot smaller. In both breeds, female dogs are likely to be smaller than males. Key characteristics. Other than size, the other features of these breeds are quite similar. Both have a solid, muscular build. Both the Akita and Shiba Inu have triangular ears and a pointed muzzle. Although, the Shiba tends to have a slightly longer snout. Both dogs have fluffy coats, bright eyes, and their tails curl up over their backs. Akita temperament. The story about Hachiko demonstrated that Akitas are loyal and devoted to their families. Akitas are also intelligent and active dogs that need lots of mental and physical stimulation. And as we know from their hunting pasts, Akitas are very brave dogs. They also make great guard dogs. Shiba Inu temperament. Shibas are alert, bold, and can have feisty personalities. These are also loyal dogs who will be loving and affectionate towards their families. Shibas can be independent, and they are also known for being quite vocal. So, be wary of this breed if you're looking for a quiet dog. Do you want to have a well-behaved, obedient and calm pet dog without spending hours in training him? Check out the first link in the description and download the Secret Training Technique guide absolutely free. It is available for free only for a limited period of time. Thanks for watching the video. Comment below if you liked the video. Please subscribe to the Little Paws Training channel if you are serious about training and grooming your dog. Also, join our Facebook group where you get all the solutions to your daily doggy problems.